What's up, guys? Back with another Lunch Break Thought. If this video helps you, go ahead and subscribe, hit that like button, it helps me out. We need to have our confidence in God. God is amazing. God is strong, God is wise, God sees all, knows all, He feels all, He created all. The more that you know about God, the more confidence you should have. Now, when the world speaks about confidence, they talk about confidence in yourself. What we see in the scriptures is that confident people are not confident in themselves. They're confident in who they are with. They are confident in whose they are. They are confident in God. For example, David, when he went up against Goliath, was not confident in his fighting abilities. He was not confident that, I'm a teenage boy and here, I can go kill this giant. I can go kill this Philistine. No, he was confident in God. He said, I'm not fighting him. God will fight on my behalf. And I will show that you don't need to be confident in yourself to have confidence. Moses himself, God spoke to him through a burning bush. And Moses was like, I can't speak. I have a stutter. And God said, don't worry. Moses came up with a list of excuses on why he himself was not the one to deliver the Israelites from the Egyptians. And God was not concerned with that because God knew that Moses wasn't going to do the work. God knew that he was going to do the work himself. So when I go out, when I talk to people, I have great confidence. Not that I'm super elegant, eloquent, I can't even speak right now. My confidence is not in that. My confidence is not in my looks or my abilities or my experience. My confidence is simply in who God is. My confidence is in God's track record. I mean, look back and look at all the things that He has done. All the ways that He has delivered His people, all the ways that He has saved people, all the ways that He has protected people, all the ways that He has done incredible things despite who it was. I mean, God spoke through a donkey. If He can speak through a donkey, He can speak through you and me. I see a lot of people not having confidence because they're looking to themselves. It's definitely a huge industry in bettering yourself, self-improvement. I mean, it is a multi-million dollar industry, maybe billion dollar industry, of self-improvement, becoming the better you. There's even quote-unquote preachers who have this message, 7 steps to the better you. I mean, it's this new age, improve yourself. What I see in the scriptures, draw your confidence in that God called you. You know, the way that I look at it is in elementary school, lining up against the gym wall, and they're picking teams. They got the team captains and they're picking teams. I was always small in school, and I was normally picked near the last. And I always imagine God, the greatest, most powerful being in all of the universe. I mean, He's outside of the universe, but the greatest being that there is, and He chose me. That gives me great confidence. You know, if Elon Musk was to call me up and said, hey, I want you on my team. I want you to go to Mars with me. I'd be like, that's dope, let's go. And my confidence would not be, man, you know what? He chose me because clearly I'm smarter than him. And clearly I have great ideas. I know nothing about rockets or cars or space travel. I know nothing. My confidence would be in what he knows. And it's the same with us and God. And that's not a perfect analogy with Elon Musk, but God knows everything. He sees everything. And if he calls you, if he chose you, which he has, that's where your confidence should be in. Not yourself, rather your confidence should be in who God is. If the God who can see all things, the God who is outside of time, has called you to be his son or his daughter, what else? There's nothing to question about that. There's nothing to be insecure about that. The only insecurities you have are when you look at yourself. Take your eyes off yourself and put them on God. That's where you get confidence from. Yes, we're imperfect. Yes, we have flaws. That's totally fine. God knows that and He still called you. Have your confidence in who God is. So that's my lunch thought for today. I hope you guys are doing well. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.